used to have a bucket at the top of the stairs, so we didn't have to go down loads of stairs to go to the toilet.
At night?
At night. And my mum came down one morning and said, "What did you do jobs in the bucket for?" I said, "I didn't." "You must have done. No one else could have reached it." "I didn't." And she chased me round and round the table, wanted to hit me and smack me because I'd done it. So, "No, I didn't, Mum, I didn't."
And, was it me, was it?
Anyway, a little later on, she came down and said, "It wasn't jobs." She said it was mud in there. One of the boys had put the mud in the bucket.
Was it you? Was it you?
Some cousins were looking after me, and I don't know what it was, but we were in the front room, and in the front garden, it's only a little tiny front garden, and in the front garden there's a little dip, and I don't know whether there was a storm on or what it was, but there was a suddenly huge flame outside the window, and I never ever did find out what that flame was. It was a bit frightening at the time.
How old were you?
Oh, must have been in 2 or 3 or something, not very old. I'd had a lot of sore throats and that, and the doctor said I had to have my tonsils out. And I can remember Dad taking me into hospital in Plasto, and nobody came to see me while I was in hospital. And when I came out of hospital, I went to stay with my grandparents in St. George's Square. Never saw my mum and dad. I thought I'd been abandoned. And I didn't see my mum and dad for a fortnight. Nobody told me anything. When I got home, there was a new baby in the house. And that's why I didn't go home. And we used to have to go and get big bag full of broken loaves.
Biscuits.
Bread.
Loaves.
And then some of them would still be hot. So, because a lot of it went before we even got home. This hot bread, it was lovely.
Come
home at lunchtime and then dash round the corner to the greengrocer's and get a pound of dates. And we would have cooked rice on the hob with milk put in it and dates for our lunch, because that's all Mum could afford at the time. I can remember Dad's brother, Uncle Fred, coming, and he gave me half a crown, and that was wonderful. I went out and I bought myself this and that and the other, comic and some chocolate and lots of bits and pieces. And a little later, Mum said, what did you do? Where's the money that Uncle Fred gave you? I've spent it. Oh, I did get told off.
So it was meant for her? It was.
No, I should have shared it with everybody.
Hey, you owe me some money then.
With interest.
Shopping, and I was sixpence short from the change. And Mum's going on at me, "Where's the other sixpence?" And I couldn't tell her. I had to wait until I could go quiet, and I said, "Oh, some sanitary towels, Mum." I couldn't tell them in front of everybody. Okay. I can remember walking around the streets of Brentford at 3 o'clock in the morning with the girl across the road star watching. Beautiful night. Beautiful starlit nights they were. Granddad was taken into hospital. He got appendicitis, so she was on her own with all us children. And I can remember whenever the siren went, she would get the broom, even in the middle of the night, she would get the broom and go out the back door and sweep the passage between us and next doors. And she was listening out for the planes so she could warn us to all get under cover. And I remember your mum and I decided we got very blasé one time. We decided to go up to bed. We weren't going to sleep under the billiard table anymore. We were going to go up to bed. So we went up to bed. And we heard a bomb coming, or a doodlebug it was. We heard one coming. And we jumped out of bed. We both got stuck in the door trying to get through it. I jumped from top to bottom of the stairs.
That's
flew under the billiard table.